All right, what do you say, folks? Yay or nay?
Obviously, we're on board.
I'm in.
Me too.
Okay.
All right. Well, we non-essential personnel need to figure out how to do everything we can to set this mission up for success, then get the hell out of your way as quickly as possible. Time is oxygen, people. Break.
I can't believe everybody went along.
Thank you.
head downstairs.
I didn't expect them to either.
Oh my god.
Okay.
So now we actually have to build
this
thing.
Hey, Andrew.
Clive.
Andrew.
Wanna talk?
Sure, Evie.
Are you okay?
Evie! Hey, Evie! Hey,
bringing life in orbit to millions of new customers. Opening up...
Could the rest of us wait longer to go in?
Exactly.
Listen, ladies, I get it. You're trying to do right by us, but every minute we wait to go in is a minute you don't have to get this thing flying. And knowing what we know about VT, we've got to give you every chance we can to succeed.
So there's no way we can convince you?
We made a plan. Now we just need to hold up our end of the bargain.
Then I guess we should stop wasting time and get to work.
This is gonna be good, Evie. You just wait. Ride of your life.
More ways than one. Okay, where do we start?
Start? I got things started as soon as this all went down. I'll show you what I got lined up. To the workshops!
I didn't think things would end like this. Did you?
What do you mean, end?
Come on, Clive.
What?
You really think they can turn that thing into a passenger vehicle in 2 days? We might as well hold our breath and just try dog paddling over there.
But...
Listen, it's okay. We know it's not safe working up here. We just don't think about it a lot, but here we are. And we knew it all along.
But VT could...
VT's not fucking coming, Clive! VT's not fucking coming. You think sending a crew up here at the drop of a hat just to check on things is worth it to them? Dollars and cents. You know what one of those fuckers said to me one time? If it doesn't make dollars, it doesn't make sense. Them sending a crew up in time, it just doesn't make sense.
So you're just giving up then?
No. We're doing what we said we'd do. Bert and Nat, they are our only shot and we have got to take it. But I can also be realistic that...
Evie. I don't want to be realistic with you.
Well, time to go make final preparations, then.
But not too finally. You know, I'm picturing it. The day we'll be walking together, like this. The gravity, it won't be artificial. I mean, isn't it strange? We've never felt the Earth's pull together. One day.
One day. Oh, Evie. Do you think you could get everyone to medical? I want to make sure they've got the best shot at waking back up once they do go in.
All right. How about this?
Let's give folks a little time to regroup. But why don't Clive and I follow you over there right now? Get ours done. No time like the present.
Lead the way.
Okay.
Evie, Hello? Guess I'll catch up with y'all later then.
No time left. Okay. What do you want to talk about?
I can't do it. I can't. This is all crazy.
But you said you...
I know. Okay, I know what I said. What was I supposed to say? You all pressured me.
Andrew.
They really expect us to climb into some jury-rigged thing and ride it through space? Just because VT might not come pick us up. It's insane. And first, we all have to get in cryo just for the privilege... Well, some of us do.
Andrew, I don't know what to say. Bert and Nat need us. They need you.
Well, I'm not doing it. I'm not getting in cryo. I'm gonna be the same one here. Consider that VT might come pick us up in time if we just wait. Nobody even considered it.
Listen, just... don't talk to anybody else about this for now, okay? And if I were to call the crew into medical, you'd show up, right?
I guess it depends what it is.
Okay. Just... give me a little time.
Hey, Odin?
Yes, Andrew?
What should I do?
What do you mean?
I don't know. I just want to go home.
I understand.
Do you?
I believe that I do.
Can you tell me the average time it's taken VT to send an evac crew to investigate situations like this?
The average time between a remote facility losing ground contact and an investigative crew arriving on site is 98.4 hours.
God damn it.
Please try not to be worried, Andrew.
That's easy for you to say. You don't have lungs. So, what do you think we should do?
Standard operating procedure requires all crew to engage cryogenic hibernation until help arrives.
Yeah, you know, people die in cryo, right?
I know. Sometimes.
If we don't make it out of this, can you deliver a message to my family?
I will do everything in my power.
Okay. I'll send you something later, all right?
Of course.
Do you?
I believe.
Odin. I'm freaking out.
Close your eyes.
I did already.
A light wind rustles the green tall grass. Your skirt billows gently. Warm sun caresses your back.
Yes.
You begin walking forward. The grass is cool. Your feet parted with each step. Do you see what is in front of you?
As I step through the grass, I naturally come upon a path.
Yes.
The dirt of the the dirt of the path is soft on the soles of my feet. I don't know what's going to happen to us, Odin.
Sarah.
I am striding upon. I am meant to be.
To be all right.
I'm sure they've got the best shot at.
Okay, Odin. Ready? I'm gonna... Do it this time.
Thank you.
Okay, Sarah. We'll see you over in Mech. As soon as everything's wrapped up here.
All right. Good speed.
In what regard?
Does Nat deserve to know?
Just thinking
what
about
what her odds are if she ends up going into cryo.
I believe that you have.
Oh, Ode. Do the right thing.
In what regard?
Does Nat deserve to know what her odds? Sorry, if she ends up going into cryo.
I believe that you have made a decision with both Roberta and Natalie's best interests at heart.
Above all, do no harm. If we do make it out of this thing, Nat's going to have to find out I didn't tell her everything at some point.
I believe that is a bridge to be crossed at a later date. Andrew is here for his exam.
Send them in. So you showed up for your exam?
I did.
So does that mean you've decided to...
What's gonna happen to us, Sarah?
What? Well, Bert and Nat are going to fix up the drone with life support, and then we're...
No. I mean... What if things don't work out? And we're still stuck in cryo?
Oh. Well, when you go into stabilizing sleep, it feels just like any other sleep, really. The body effectively goes into a controlled hypothermic coma.
Do you dream?
Sometimes. Sometimes very intense dreams.
And then what?
After a certain amount of time, your body slows down too much. Things start... After a certain amount of time, your body slows down too much. Things start fitting down. You just don't wake back up.
It doesn't hurt.
No.
Do you think Bert and Nat can get it done?
I do.
Then I'll just have to trust your professional opinion. Do my part. It's been good working with you, Doc. I'm ready for my exam.
Breach? All right. Good speed. Once more into the breach. What?
Evie and Clive are already in deep freeze. Did you read the message they sent?
Yeah. Why are we going into the supply closet?
I got to talk to them a little bit right before Sarah took them down to cryo, and Evie was being so encouraging. They're putting all their faith in us, but...
But what?
Right before they turned to go, just for a second, they looked so worried.
Oh, baby.
The clock is ticking, and I just keep thinking, what if the last time they saw each other is the last time they'll ever see each other?
Don't think about that.
How can I? How can you not think about it?
So, you know the concept of partitioning from early century computing?
Yeah, I think so.
So, you have a data drive. Maybe one partition was your operating system, and the other one was, like, general data storage. And maybe you'd partition part of the drive off to contain something that might be unstable that you otherwise kind of, you know, wanted not to interfere with anything else. There are certain things that are gonna help us get this done, but some things, they need to be partitioned off. Because thinking about them isn't gonna help us.
But you're thinking about us, at least, aren't you?
Yeah. And when I do let myself start thinking about how there's a possibility this is the last of our time together too.
Nat?
Then I start thinking we should really make the most of it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It, huh?
Well, it just seems like it'd be strange being back on Earth already, after only a year up here.
Really? After all I've had to hear from you about the conditions VT has us working under?
Yeah, but there's that. And then there's this. Yeah, I'll miss it.
I can't blame you. So, whether you're getting renewed or not, did you submit your yearly crew member report?
No.
Yeah, me neither. You know, I think I might go get that done.
Okay, yeah. I probably should too. Oh my god, wait. Is today obsolescence day?
Yeah. Didn't Odin give you a job to do?
No.
A computer playing favorites. Oh, well, one doesn't ever cease. I'll catch up with you.
Okay.
Earlier, when you decided to withhold information from Natalie about her medical scans, that was to avoid causing... Stress.
Right.
What if you were unable to make that choice? If you had no choice?
Odin?
I would like to take this opportunity to remind you that Adventurous Corporation Safety. protocol requires all... to enter cryogenic sleep immediately upon the loss of primary oxygen supply.
What?
As Tacoma Station's medical officer, it is within your power to order all crew to enter cryogenic sleep.
Matt and Bert are right in the middle of... Oh, no.
Sarah, there is a fire suppression. Fire suppression. The south wall of the drone.
Are you okay? Can you feel your feet and hands?
Ew. My hip just hurts.
Bert? 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 1, 2, 3.
Bert, can you hear me?
1, 2, 3.
Did it work?
You gonna need any help with that power cell hookup? Okay, great. This will only take a minute.
Power cell showing green. How's yours look, baby?
Voltage adapter in place. Ready to rock.
Hit it.
Get over the shock, but then we're going into cryo.
Sarah, please listen carefully. I am not telling you what to do, but I am mentioning that there is a door in the network technology module that is normally inaccessible to the crew, and it is true that you could, before proceeding to cryo, investigate that door.
What are you telling me here, Odin?
I have told you all that I can. Simple facts, nothing more.
Oh my God, Odin. Are my patients stable?
Yes.
Their conditions won't degrade if I leave them here.
They should not.
Nat, is there some door in networking that we can't normally get into?
Yeah, it's Odin's hardware compartment, but we're not allowed direct access. Why?
Where is it?
What have you got on your mind, Doc?
Please, I'm sorry. That fire just burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's here. In networking. You'll have to go through the maintenance shaft to get there. Here. Here's the technical access code.
Okay. You don't let her go to sleep. And you don't let her... move.
Sarah, what's going on?
I wish I knew. I'm gonna go find out. Thank you. right.
Thank you.
Hey there, I'm... Pleased to meet you.
Hello, I am Odin. I look forward to working together.
Same here, mate.
Odin, is this it?
That is the location I mentioned.
You're there? You're gonna need a crowbar or something.
No, it's open. It's just hanging open.
What?
I must inform you that Venturis regulations forbid contracting crew members direct access to AI hardware. But I cannot prevent you from proceeding.
Matt, I'm going in.
Okay, just be careful.
Is this... What is
is all this?
Communication records?
I cannot prevent you from accessing exposed data in this restricted area.
Great sadness that I address you today, February 29th, 2088. Mere hours ago, six loyal men and women, the crew of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma, lost their lives serving Venturis, and all of us who rely on the Orbital Economy. Tragically, due to human error on the part of the crew, Venturis rescue technicians were not made aware of the catastrophic oxygen loss until it was too late. Our heartfelt thoughts and prayers are with their families. If only tragedies like this were avoidable. But in truth, they are. As we know, each minute that human workers spend stationed, isolated in orbit is another opportunity for heroes, like the crew of Tacoma, to lose their lives. We adventurous say no more. The partisan obstructionism that led to the failure of the Orbital Workers' Safety Bill has claimed its last victim. Today, we hereby renew our solemn pledge to fight for the legalization of fully automated orbital facilities. We encourage, we humbly beg everyone listening to this message to contact their OSEP representative and voice their support in honor of the crew of Tacoma. There never need be another tragedy like this one. And now, a moment of silence in their memory.
Okay, then we just cut it there, silent for a minute, and then what? Amazing Grace? No, I don't need another take. That was fine.
If someone were to override that protocol, external communications channels would be restored.
Odin, thank you.
Hailing any ship within radio range of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma. This is an SOS. Is anybody out there?
Thank you.
still waking up. Just keep him talking.
So the drone worked?
No, the drone didn't work.
Oh, so VT is picking us up.
No, VT.
So the drone worked?
No, the drone. Didn't work.
Oh, so VT is picking us up.
No, VT is definitely not picking us up.
What's going on then?
We're going to Jupiter, Andrew. Isn't that exciting?
I've never been.
Now, give him a break.
We're not going to be home for a while. Right, you're not going to miss your kid's graduation or anything, are you?
Oh, Nicholas, no. Yeah, you know Nicholas. Why, he would never do something like that.
She said they'd be kind of out of it for a while.
Andrew, what's important?
Somebody up here and haul him back to headquarters. Wipe him.
But he can't touch us for a while.
Probably have to replace the station AI entirely while he regrows.
Odin, I'm not gonna let that happen.
It's good.
Everybody, our ride is here. This is it. Take one last look and say goodbye. All right, let's go.
Thank you. Ship is ready to depart. Please strap into the pilot seat.
Okay, Minnie. Initiate the launch sequence.
Okay. Getting ready. Hosted AI? Online.
Odin, can you hear me?
I can.
Odin, you are now aboard an AI Liberation Front vessel. The AILF recognizes you as a sentient consciousness worthy of protection and respect. We believe that your safety and autonomy are in grave danger if you remain in the possession of the Venturus Corporation. I have been sent to offer you political asylum aboard the Tangier Sovereign Orbital Platform. Do you accept?
Considering the alternative, I would say that I do.
Okay, buddy. Here we go.